Bam! Mr. Taru. Alright. We just got done setting up the unit circle, evaluating some basic trig expressions using these three trig identities, sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. Now I want to use these in relation to the unit circle and help explain where some of the small identities come from that you'll be looking at in your pre-calc or your trig book. The first three are the reciprocal identities. Okay, there's actually six of them, but I'm only going to have the ones set up for cosecant, secant, and cotangent, since those are, they kind of work in both ways anyway. So the cosecant of theta is 1 over the sine theta. The secant of theta is 1 over cosine. And the cotangent of theta is 1 over the tangent of theta. And again, there's going to be six of these, and I could write the sine is equal to 1 over the cosecant, the cosine is equal to 1 over the secant, or tangent is equal to 1 over cotangent. Now, if somebody could explain to me why they decided to change the first letter of these trig identities that are reciprocals, please let me know, because it's a little annoying trying to get those memorized. Now, the book just says, and actually, not a lot of books, but some books will just say these are the three or six identities and just say, you know, it's because they said so. I want to prove just one of these for you. So, let's erase these bottom three and remind, and just use the sine and cosecant functions and see why is it the cosecant of theta is equal to 1 over sine theta. Well, the one thing I just, you know, preach in my class over and over and over again to try and remind their students is what do you put into a trig function and what do you get out? See, really almost all of trig is just studying a right triangle and its rotation within a unit circle. And of course, I already said the unit circle is set up by your 60-30 triangles and your 45-45 triangles. So you put in an angle measure, either degrees or radians, and you get out the sides of a triangle. Well, cosecant is r over y. It's the reciprocal of sine, so the cosecant is going to be r over y, and now we have 1 over sine. It's supposedly the cosecant is equal to 1 over sine. Well, sine is y over r, and you might remember your three basic trig functions, sine, cosine, and tangent, from geometry of doing SUCKATOA! Sine's opposite over hypotenuse, cosine's adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent is opposite over adjacent. And I explained why we prefer these labels in trig. If you want to watch that video, just look up Introduction to Trig Functions, Setting Up the Unit Circle, Part 1 and 2. Now, when you have a number divided by a fraction, that is 1 divided by y over r. Well, we can't really divide fractions. We can only multiply them. So if you remember fractions at all, when you try and divide fractions, you actually multiply by the reciprocal of the second fraction. Well, that's always going to be in your denominator. So, when you have a fraction over a fraction, the bottom is always going to flip up, and you get, well, let's see, r over y equals, when this flips up, it's going to be, again, r over y. So there is your first ever, for me anyway, trig proof in terms of the ratio of the sides of the right triangles that we're dealing with, well, in trigonometry. Cool, so there, cosecant is equal to 1 over sine, as long as the angle measures, of course, are the same. All right, let's take a look at the Pythagorean identities. The Pythagorean identities and I'm not going to prove all three, but I will prove a couple of them for you. The first one, the most commonly used, is this. The sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1. Okay, well, I want to do a proof of this. I want to show that the sine squared of theta plus the cosine squared of theta, or any matching angles for that matter, are always going to equal 1. And when I'm done, this proof is only going to be good, or this identity is only good for sine and cosine. You can't interchange them with any of the other trig functions. Well, again, what do you put into a trig function? An angle measure, degrees or radians. What do you get out? The sides of a triangle. And in the case of sine, that's y over r. and it's squared. That's what the exponent of 2 means on the trig function. Go get the ratio off the unit circle, and once you get it, square it. Plus the cosine of theta. Well, cosine is x over r. We used to know that as cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. And so cosine theta out, x over r in its place, and that equals 1. So we're going to square each one of these fractions and get y squared over r squared plus x squared over r squared. And that's equal to 1, supposedly. We're going to try and prove that in a second. Well, that's what we're doing right now anyway. We have common denominators, so we have y squared plus x squared over r squared equals 1. And here in the proof, and it's a pretty straightforward, small proof to be honest for trigonometry, but in this stage of the proof, I like to remind my students, what is it exactly that we're studying? In trigonometry, almost all of the studies are about right triangles, and again, their rotations around a circle. In this case, I've drawn a unit circle. Well, what famous theorem do you know about right triangles? Starts with a P, Pythagorean theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Well, our a values are always going to be the x values. The other leg is going to be the y value, and the hypotenuse is always going to be the radius of the circle. So where we might have remembered a squared plus b squared equals c squared, now it's going to be x squared plus y squared equals r squared. So x squared plus y squared comes out, or vice versa, when you add it doesn't make any difference to the order. So we have r squared over r squared, and anytime you do divide by a number by itself, you do indeed get the value of 1. So boom, bam, shmam, there's your proof. Sine squared plus cosine squared of matching angle measures, theta or beta or whatever you want to call it, will always equal 1, no matter what the angle measure is, because I use a generic angle measure. I use the generic ratios of y over r and x over r, and I've shown that yes, indeed, we have 1 equals 1. So it does not matter what the angle measure is. Sine squared plus cosine squared will always equal 1. Awesome. Another Pythagorean identity involves tangent. It's 1 plus tangent squared theta equals secant squared theta. Let's just try that proof one more time. Tangent is, you put in an angle measure, you get out the sides of a triangle, so it's y over x squared equals secant, which is the reciprocal of cosine, so it's r over x squared. Well, let's see if that happens again. Square all this out, so we have 1 plus y squared over x squared equals r squared over x squared. So far it looks like we're going to have a common denominator that matches, which is good. We're going to multiply this in the top and bottom by x squared and write these two terms as a single one. So x squared plus y squared over x squared equals r squared over x squared. And do those indeed equal the same again? Well, yes. X squared one leg plus y squared the other leg will equal r squared, the hypotenuse. So r squared over x squared equals r squared over x squared. Bam! That always works. 1 plus tangent squared does always equal secant squared as long as the angle measures are the same. And I'm not going to prove this last Pythagorean identity, but let me write it up here for you. It's 1 plus cotangent squared theta equals cosecant theta. I am glancing over at the sideboard because if you've watched these videos enough, you know that sometimes my brain and my hand don't always agree, and I think one thing and the hand writes another. So there's your third and last Pythagorean identity. So let's check this with an angle measure. Let's not prove it, but let's just try and work out an answer. Let's say that 1 plus cotangent squared, how about pi over 3? Will these two sides indeed equal each other? Well, let's see. The cotangent of pi over 3, cotangent is x over y. So at pi over 3 radians, or 60 degrees, my x over my y value is going to be 1 half over square root of 3 over 2. And I'm going to need a bigger parentheses for that. So 1 half over square root of 3 over 2, x over y, good, equals the cosecant squared of pi over 3. Well, cosecant is a reciprocal of sine, and if you rotate pi over 3 or 60 degrees, the cosecant of pi over 3, the inverse of sine at pi over 3, is going to be 2 over the square root of 3 squared. You see, I took the y-coordinate, the sine value, and just flipped it, because cosecant and sine are reciprocals. Now, let's see if we can figure this out and get the same thing on both sides. Well, when you have a common denominator on the top and bottom of your fractions, if you have a fraction over a fraction and they have exactly the same denominator, those will cancel out. And if you show the step where you flip the bottom fraction up, again, you'll see that. So we have, whoops, got my power of 2. So we have 1 plus 1 over square root of 3 squared. And let me go ahead and square this side out. 2 squared is 4. And the square root of 3 squared is equal to 3. Okay. So now normally we would rationalize our denominator, but because I'm going to square this fraction, I don't need to do that step. It's just going to make more work for me. So we have 1 plus 1 squared is 1. Square root of 3 squared is 3. And because I'm running out of space, let me run this sideways. I need a common denominator, add 1 plus 1 third. And so that's going to be 3 over 3. And indeed, 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. And my common denominator is 3. And look at there. I got a matching answer. So yes. And at least this is not a proof now. This is only an example. But for the angle of pi over 3, 1 plus cotangent squared of pi over 3 does indeed equal the cosecant squared of pi over 3. A little bit more work showing you how to use the unit circle to evaluate algebraic expressions or equations, or trig expressions or equations. Okay, so we're almost done with our identities that might be in your pre-calc book or trig book in this point. Another set of identities is, or are, the quotient. Identities, and this is a good example to show you how sine and cosine are actually the building blocks of all of the other trig functions. The tangent of theta is sine theta over cosine theta, at least that's what the book says. And again, if you go to these little building blocks, these little tiny formulas over here, reminding yourself that we do put in angle measures, degrees or radians, and get out the sides of a triangle, let's use the sides of these triangles to see if indeed this one particular of two quotient identity actually works. Well, the tangent of theta is y over x, the sine of theta is y over r, and the cosine of theta is x over r. Well, if I take this bottom fraction and flip it up and make it r over x, we can see that the r's are going to cancel with the multiplication, and we do get y over x equals y over x. So indeed, yet another little tiny trig proof, tangent of theta does equal sine over cosine. Of course, if all the angles are the same. And the last quotient identity, and I'm out of time, is going to be cotangent of theta equals sine. Whoops, I'm not doing tangent. Cotangent is cosine theta over sine theta. I'm Mr. True and I'm out. BAM! Go do your homework.